Seem to whisper, I love you. Birds singing in the sycamore tree. So dream a little dream of me. Oh, say nighty night and kiss me. Just hold me tight and say that you miss me. While I'm
here is Soapy, the main character of our story.
Honey, let me fit your vest.
Arnie, when was the last time you called me like that?
I haven't excused them.
Don't say like I never loved you. My love was for you, and is it and will always be never change.
Okay, honey, just tell me what you want to buy.
You are definitely the best husband in the world. I'm wondering if I could have a new warm coat, cause you know, winter is coming.
Winter's coming? Time's really flying. Winter's knocking at my door again. What should I do to survive this 3 months cold weather?
My hopes for the winters are not very high. Sailing away on a ship? Nope. Southern skies? Absolutely not. For winters is 3 months in the prison on Black Whale Island.
Three months of food every day and a bed every night. 3 months safe from the cold north wind and safe from cops. Oh, that's my wildest dream.
For years, Black Whale's Island has been Soapy's winter home, while rich New Yorkers make their larger plans to go to Florida or to the shore of the Mediterranean Sea each winter. Poor Soapy makes his small plans to commit the crime to be transferred to the island's prison.
It's not that I want to become a bad guy. There are places in the city where I can go and ask for food and a bed. And 3 months will pass quickly. But...
poor you, Sabi. If you don't mind, you can come and stay at our place. We still have a spare basement.
That's so nice of you to say so. I'll pay you a rent.
Oh, you don't have to do so.
But would you mind taking a shower?
How about your family? What is your plan for the future?
No, prison is still better. The prison has rules that I will have to follow. But in prison, a gentleman's own life is still his own life.
Soapy, having decided to go to the island, at once begins to move toward his desire by successfully committing a crime. This is where the best food and the best people in the best clothes appear every evening.
There are many easy ways of committing a crime. The most pleasant way is to go and have a good dinner at this fine restaurant. Then I will say that I have no money to pay. And then a cop will be called. It will all be done very quietly. What should I eat? I shouldn't eat too much. I don't want the restaurant people to feel any real anger.
Good morning, sir.
Oh, look like her soapy has come up with a new brilliant idea.
Do you see the man who did it, sir?
Yes, it's me. I'm the one who did it.
Yes, it's me, sir. Hurry up and catch me.
What is the jerk doing? He's admitting that he's committed the crime? I would be an idiot to believe so. The one who should have done this couldn't be staying here and waiting for me. Like this, he would have run as far as possible.
Thank you, sir.
Hey, you!
Hey, I'm here! Where are you going?
This time, Soapy chooses another restaurant, which is not as fine as the one on Broadway. The people who go there are not so rich, and the food is not very good also.
This time, surely there will be no problems. I'm going to succeed. Let's go, Soapy. You can do this.
Are you dining alone, sir?
Yes.
Would you like a drink with your meal, sir?
I have a wine, please.
Definitely, sir. What would you like for your meal?
What do you recommend?
Our special for today is risotto with lobsters.
I'll take it, please.
Please wait for a while. Your meal will be ready in a few minutes. Wait! Excuse me, sir. You haven't made the meal yet.
You know what? Money and I are strangers.
So you mean you don't have money to pay for your meal, right?
Correctly, you got what I mean. You don't have to make yourself busy. Call a cop to catch me.
Cops! No cop for you! It's just me who can take care of you.
Let's get ready to rumble!
Sophie has traveled almost half a mile before he tries again. This time, he feels very certain that he would be successful.
Wow, over there's a beautiful young woman, and a cop's also standing nearby. This is a good chance. She seems to be a very nice young lady. We will not want a strange man to speak to her. I'll tease her and she will ask the cop for help.
Hello, beauty, Camilla. Did you want to come and play with me?
You only need to move your hand and we'll be on the highway to my heaven.
Hello, Sean. As long as you buy me a drink. Come on, honey. Let's go.
Our genius Soapy has come up with a new plan again.
My umbrella.
Oh, is it? Why don't you call a cop? I took your umbrella. Why don't you call a cop? There's one standing in the corner.
That is, you know how these things happen? If that's your umbrella, I'm very sorry. I found it this morning in a restaurant. If you say it's yours, I hope you will...
It's mine! Hey! Wait!
My sweetheart, thanks for this warm coat.
Now, sweetheart, it must be paid by this $3,000 coat.
We are going to enjoy the warmest winter ever.
Yeah, yeah, you say that every year. Let's go home, it's turning cold out here.
Everything you want.
Sophie suddenly freezes. Peach is standing there watching the busy life until it turns dark.
In this part of the city, streets are brighter and hearts are more joyful than in other parts. Our Sophie may be thinking of something else to try.
He's one of those college boys. He won't hurt anything. We had orders to let them shout.
Is no cop going to touch me? The islands really begins to become as far as heaven.
Day long, I flaunted the law in their face. And not one of them, not a single one of those cops mind me and lift a little finger to prevent it.
I should stop here. I should give up all hopes of 3 months safe from the cold north wind on Black Whale's Island. I could not be arrested. That's my destiny for this winter. Now I better come back home, although my home is only a seat in a park.
Oh, he stops. What happened? What is he looking at?
In those days, his life contained such things as mother, and flowers, and high hopes, and friends, and clean socks, and clean clothes.
Sophie's mind is ready for something like this. He has come to the old church at the right time. There is a sudden and wonderful change in his soul. He sees with sick fear how he has fallen. He sees his worthless day, his wrong desire, his dead hopes, the lost power of his mind. And also, in a moment, his heart answered this change in his soul. He would fight to change his life. He would pull himself up out of the mud. He would make a man of himself again.
I'm young enough. I will find my own purpose in life and follow it. And I can find a job tomorrow. I know a man who had once offered me a job and I will find that man tomorrow. And I will be somebody in this world. I will...
What are you doing hanging around here?
Nothing.
You think I believe that?
I am.
Come along.
Next. Guilty or not guilty? Oh, you were picked up outside of the church.
My honor, I just stood there to refresh my soul. I had just undergone the most salutary spiritual experience. I'm a reformed man now. And today I plan to apply for a position.
No candlestick were found on you.
No. I assure you, sir.
Maybe you were trying to rob the merry bell.
No.
Not even a dam was found. 3 months on the island.
For what?
Vacancy. No visible means of support. Escape.
Seem to whisper, I love you. Birds singing in the sycamore trees. Dream a little dream of me. Say nighty night and kiss me. Just hold me tight and tell me miss me while I'm alone and blue as can be. Dream a little dream of me. Stars fading, but I linger on, dear, still craving your kiss. Sunbeams find you, sweet dreams that leave all worries behind you. But